So I want to talk to you guys about two must-have features when you're looking at buying a new AV receiver. Hey guys, I'm Gene Della Sala with Audioholics, and today I want to talk to you about what you must have when you purchase a new AV receiver. See, you got to think ahead. When you go out and you drop $800, $1,000, $2,000 on an AV receiver, you want to make sure that this is going to be somewhat, and I stress the word somewhat, future-proof. You want to make sure that you're going to get many years of life out of it. So pretty much all of the receivers today are at least HDMI 2.0. You usually have at least six HDMI out inputs and one output, sometimes two outputs. So you're covered on your HDMI features, you're generally covered on your processing features. You're going to get Atmos whether you want it or not. You're going to get DTS:X. You're going to have some streaming capabilities built in, whether you do some music management with Denon HiOS or you use the Yamaha MusicCast, or NAD has BlueOS. But all that stuff is just kind of, you know, that's already there and that's already assumed. But what's really critical, in my opinion, especially if you want to keep this receiver, you know, 5, 6, 7 years or more, is you should look for a receiver that has independent dual subwoofer outputs. Now, most of the entry-level receivers, $500 or less, generally have one subwoofer output. And if they have two, they tend to be paralleled outputs. So they're identical outputs. You can't adjust digital delay and level independently. So if you want to get the best subwoofer setup, you really, if you're going to do multi-sub, because I want you guys to upgrade to have two subs in your systems. If you only have one sub, I'm going to keep pounding this into your heads until you add a second sub, just because you get better bass distribution, you get more output capability. There's just so many benefits to having two subs. And when you do a two sub system, you really want to have dual outputs, where you have independent delay and independent level control. And then the second option I would urge you to consider when you're getting an AV receiver is to get one that has preamp outputs. And why you want preamp outputs is if you want to upgrade the power someday, if you decide you get a bigger speaker system, or you want to get a system that just has more output capability, you want to have those preamp outputs. And generally speaking, the cheaper receivers don't have multi-channel preamp outputs anymore because they're too focused on putting all these other features with the latest in HDMI and Atmos and everything else. So if it's coming between a receiver that costs, let's say, $800 versus $1,100, I know that's a big stretch to go up $300 more, especially in this time, I would tell you to save your pennies and spend the extra $300, because you don't want to be in a situation 3 years down the road. You'd be like, you know what? I want to add a second sub. I want to add more power. I got better speakers. I got the audio upgrade bug. And now you got to start all over again. You got to dump that receiver on eBay for a third of what you paid for it, if you're lucky. So spend a little bit extra more money now. Look for a receiver that has multi-channel preamp outputs, at least the front channels, so you could at least add power to the front channels, and then dual independent subwoofer outputs. Now, if you get a receiver that has the multi-channel outputs, but it doesn't have the dual independent subwoofer outputs, there is an option to add an external box, like a mini DSP, and Parts Express has a box now as well. So there is an option to add a DSP box that will give you, you'll put one input to it from your receiver and you'll get two independent outputs where you could control level and delay. And that's something we'll talk about in another video. So I'm curious, what receiver are you using? What brand are you using? What model are you using? Are you thinking about doing an upgrade? Are you regretting you didn't get the next level up that gave you these features that I'm talking about? Please share your comments down below. Make sure you subscribe to our channel if you're not already subscribed. Like this video, hit the bell notification so you get more notices when we drop videos, the newest videos. Don't forget about our Patreon channel at patreon.com/audioholics. There's lots of benefits to being a Patreon member. And until next time, my friends, keep listening.